Britney Spears was not completely free to the conservatorship on November 12th. Why not? And what is it going to take to get her financial freedom? Well, let's break it down. My name is Christopher Melcher. I'm a California attorney and legal commentator. And it was incredible to be outside the LA courthouse on November 12th when we got the news that the conservatorship had been terminated. If you were not there in person or didn't see the live stream, it was absolutely amazing. The crowd came alive. All of this support for so many years for Britney, the great relief of hearing the conservatorship was terminated. It was also bittersweet because I really enjoy seeing everyone at these rallies, and I hope that we can continue doing it as this case progresses. So the conservatorship over the person was terminated on November 12th. All of the personal liberties that had been taken away from Britney in 2008 were restored to her on that day. But we had heard something about a trust, and there were details, and that was going to take a bit until her financial freedom was restored to her. And I've gone now and looked through all the documents and understand what happened. But before I can go into those details, I need to talk about what trusts are so we have that foundation. These trusts are mostly created to avoid what's called probate. It's a process that occurs after somebody dies. On death, an estate is created where all of their assets and debts go into. And if they had a will, their property after payment to creditors will pass according to their plan in the will, but court approval is needed. The court needs to make sure that this will is valid, needs to give notice to other potential heirs and creditors. All those people have an opportunity to speak up. There's administration that happens with attorneys who charge a percentage of the value of the estate for fees. And then finally, distributions are made to the heirs. Nobody likes this process because it's time-consuming, expensive, and uncertain. And that's why we have family trusts, or what are sometimes called revocable trusts. This is basically a contract that allows the passage of property outside of probate so we don't have to go through all that stuff. And there are three roles in a trust: the settlor, who creates the trust and funds it with their property, and also retains the power to change the trust. That's why they call it revocable. Then there's the trustee. It's the person who will hold title to these assets and has a fiduciary duty to distribute them or hold them, whatever the plan was, according to the settlor. And then finally, the beneficiary, the person who's going to benefit from this trust. In most cases, it's one person who serves in all three of these roles initially. And that was the case for Britney Spears when she created the SJB Trust in 2004, years before the conservatorship. Britney Spears created that trust, so she was the settlor, and she retained control over it as trustee and was also the beneficiary of that trust. Once the settlor dies, the trust becomes irrevocable. It can no longer be changed. A successor trustee is appointed who will then carry out the wishes of the settlor as expressed in the trust document. The beneficiary is replaced with a contingent beneficiary, typically a spouse or child or children of the settlor. And in this way, the property is distributed according to the plan of the settlor without having to go to court. For Britney's trust in 2008, when the conservatorship was placed upon her, she was removed as trustee and others were put into place as successors. I'm not going to go into the background of the trust in this video because there's already a bunch of great videos on that on a channel called Britney's SWAT Team on YouTube. So go check that out. They have 9 videos there that detail the history of the trust. The purpose of this video is to talk about how this trust got in the way of completely freeing Britney on November 12th. When Britney's legal team and the attorney representing John Zabel, the temporary conservator of the estate, were preparing for the termination, they discovered that Jamie Spears, or the conservatorship team, had buried in secretly some terms into Britney's trust to lock her into their control even after the conservatorship would have ended. That's why Mr. Zabel filed a petition on November 12th to eliminate those restrictions so Britney could have her financial freedom back. In the petition for substituted judgment filed by Mr. Zabel on November 12th, he stated that he needed to bring this action so that he could transition Britney's property from the conservatorship into her trust because many of these assets were held outside of her trust for some reason. Also, He noted that the estate planning changes that had been made by the conservatorship team buried within the instrument prevented Ms. Spears from ever amending or revoking her estate plan without first obtaining a court order. These changes that the conservatorship made were improper and were also hidden from the court. There was no legitimate reason to require court approval to change Britney's revocable trust because it was intended to be revocable, meaning that she retained the power when she created this thing to change it or even throw the whole thing out. But Jamie Spears and his co-conservator of the estate at that time, Andrew Wallet, had another purpose. They wanted to put into this trust a provision that allowed them to continue controlling Britney even if the conservatorship ended and they failed to disclose that fact to the court. In their petition for substituted judgment of August 14, 2017, they said that the purpose of the petition was to request authority to create a new estate plan for Ms. Spears as her children were born after the first one was created. They claimed that Britney had provided her input on this and desire to make the change, which they called a scheme, and I agree, it was a scheme. Nothing is mentioned in the petition that Andrew Wallet and Jamie Spears filed about making this revocable trust irrevocable without court approval. I imagine that was buried in some fine print of the document that was attached to the petition, but they never informed the court that this was one of their hidden purposes. And Britney's court-appointed attorney, Sam Ingham, never bothered to catch it or didn't care enough to read the document and understand it himself. The court clearly believed that this trust would remain revocable after the amendment that Jamie Spears and Andrew Wallet were proposing, because in its order of May 3, 2018, the court stated that this was a revocable trust. However, because of the condition that Andrew Wallet and Jamie Spears had snuck into this document, it could not be changed without court approval, and therefore it was truly not revocable by her. An interesting find in the petition that John Zabel filed on November 12th is that Jamie Lynn Spears, the sister of Britney Spears, never acted as trustee. Well, we knew that Jamie Lynn had been appointed as a successor trustee of this trust, but now we're being told that she never acted. The November 12th petition states that Jamie Lynn Spears never undertook any of the steps to actually become trustee. That's very odd because she was named as a successor trustee in 2018 as a result of these changes that Andrew Wallet and Jamie Spears had requested. And last year, Jamie Spears went back to court asking for some additional authority over this trust and failed to mention that Jamie Lynn had never taken control and actually made it appear that she was acting as trustee. In the petition that Jamie Spears filed on August 21, 2020, to direct the trustee to put certain funds in blocked accounts, Jamie tells the court that Jamie Lynn was named as the trustee. And that's half-speak. He omitted the fact that Jamie Lynn had never taken steps to become trustee. They needed to tell the court that. That was the court's expectation when it approved the amendment that Jamie Lynn, the sister, would take control of the trust. But no one, including Britney's own court-appointed attorney, felt it necessary to inform the court that its wishes or order had not been followed. So what happens next? John Zabel in his recent petition states that Britney wants to do a whole new estate plan, so she's going to be the settlor or creator of that plan. We are not told who the trustee will be, and there's no reason why Britney cannot be the trustee of her own trust. She can hire investment managers to give her advice on how to deal with her money if she wants that. Or if she wants secrecy, she could place somebody else in the role of trustee. But coming out of this abusive conservatorship, I think that's a bad idea for her to place anyone other than herself in control of her life and money. I assume Britney will be the sole beneficiary of her trust during her lifetime, and that if she dies, her money will go to her children. But we have not been shown the proposed trust. It was attached to this petition that Mr. Zabel filed, but it was all redacted, meaning blacked out. And that was what Britney apparently wanted. She wanted to maintain privacy over her estate planning, which most people do, and I respect her wishes. All of these loose ends should be tied up and approved by the December 18th hearing on this petition. The next big hearing is set for January 19th, where the court will consider all of these fees that have been requested by the attorneys that formerly represented Jamie Spears in his capacity as conservator, the fees that Lynn Spears, the mother, is seeking from Britney, and the fees that the court-appointed attorney is seeking from Britney. I don't know if Matthew Rosengart has all the information that he needs to oppose those fee requests, so he could ask for a continuance. If it does go forward, I hope to see you there, and I also hope that you got some benefit out of this video, and I will see you next time.